In this video, I'm going to be telling you about the biography facts of TB Joshua, controversial talk, and many things you probably don't know about him. So, if you are new to this channel, please ensure to subscribe by clicking on the subscribe button. And also, don't forget to bell the notification button for more updates whenever we post new videos. You can also follow us at Ejimozy, Ejimozy, on Instagram. So, without further ado, let's get started. Prophet TB Joshua was born on the 12th June 1963 in Arigidi, Akoko, Nigeria, and he goes by the full name Temitope Balogun Joshua. According to Joshua's official biography, some unusual circumstances surround his birth, as he spent 15 months in his mother's womb and narrowly avoided death after a quarry explosion near his house sent through rock to the top of the roof just 7 days after his birth. It was also alleged that Joshua's birth was prophesied 100 years prior to the time he was born. Prophet TB Joshua, attending St. Stephen Anglican Primary School in Arigidi, Akoko, Nigeria between 1971 and 1977, but failed to complete 1 year of secondary school education. When he was in school, he was known as Small Pastor because of his love for the Bible. He confessed to have done various casual jobs after his schooling, including carrying chicken waste at a poultry farm. He organized Bible study for local children and interview evening school during his period. Joshua attempted the Nigerian military, but this dream was thwarted due to a breakdown in the train, which left him stranded for 6 days. TB Joshua gained reputation for spiritual prowess after confronting a madman in the school premises and collecting his weapon from him. He was reported to be the leader of the Scripture Union in school. TB Joshua started and founded the Synagogue Church of All Nations in 1987. In 1987, he visited a prayer mountain, and this was to seek the face of the Lord. There he fasted and prayed for 40 days and 40 nights. He wrote that in an heavenly vision, he received divine anointing and covenant from God to start his own ministry. TB Joshua started and founded the Synagogue Church of All Nations, also known as SCOAN, in 1987 with just a few members, which has grown to have plenty of worshippers in Nigeria and even beyond. Prophet TB Joshua is indeed popular across Africa, Latin America, and even Asia. And there, he has conducted crusade and deliverance services with thousands and millions of people attending such meetings. The Church Society has released video claiming to document the healing and incurable disabilities and illness such as HIV and AIDS, cancer, and many others, even in the ministry, which sometimes causes controversies among non-members of the church. Even with his deliverance section, where he chases out spirits and demons during his services. He claimed to be a prophet and has prophesied over major events in the world, such as Michael Jackson's death, the attack during the Boston Marathon in America, and the outcome of the AFCON matches. He predicted the crash of Malaysian airline MH370 several months before the incident, and so many others, which has caused several talks and arguments. The Synagogue Church of All Nations runs a Christian television station called Emmanuel TV, available on all satellite and social media platforms. These shows were also aired weekly on a number of television stations across Africa. Pastor TB Joshua had millions of followers, including top politicians and top stars. On 12th September 2014, a guest house allegedly collapsed in SCOAN premises in Lagos, killing at least 115 people, 84 of them who are from South Africa. And this is because many people from other nations of the world always visit SCOAN, that is the Synagogue Church of All Nations, weekly and every day to worship. And according to reports, SCOAN Center is the most visited tourist religion center in Nigeria. The BBC described him as Nigerian best known tele-evangelist. It was reported that Pastor TB Joshua's prayer ended Tontodike's 14-year smoking addiction, which made her very sad after hearing the demise of the pastor. Emmanuel's YouTube channel had over 1,800,000 subscribers and 400 million views before it was closed in April 2021 and under the allegation of hate speech. It has been in the world's most viewed Christian ministry on the platform. Google ranked one of Emmanuel's TV videos on YouTube as the fourth most viewed clip ever within Nigeria. He has received so many awards and honored for his humanitarian service, even to the world at large. He was honored as the Ambassador of Peace by the Arewa Youth Forum, a predominantly Muslim organization, in appreciation for his humanitarian endeavors. He was also recognized as one of the Africa's 50 most influential people by the Pan-Africans magazine, the African Report of News African magazine. For his consistent humanitarian work, he was conferred with the National Honor of OFR by the Nigerian government in 2008. Yes, he has done so many things, even for many people, as he has helped the poor, helped those in need. He has provided so many things for so many individuals. That's why they cannot forget him. TB Joshua also wrote and published several books, including The Mirror, The Step Between You and The Cure, Daily Times with God, and What the Future Holds, and so many others. Prophet TB Joshua was regarded by Forbes as the third richest pastor in Nigeria, with estimated net worth of about $10 million to $15 million. The wife of TB Joshua, Evelyn, on Sunday, after his death, revealed that the cleric spent his last moment on earth praying for India due to the increase in the COVID-19 cases in the country. The wife noted that her husband was found dead in his office after conducting his service in the church. Evelyn was quoted as saying he ended the race prayerfully. She revealed that he spent about 3 hours in prayers before the last service on the mountain. I was looking very healthy. She said he never showed any sign of illness or worry, and that his main concern was about the prayer line they offered to Indians against the COVID-19 pandemic. Afterward, he came up to shower and she left him to have some time to prepare for service. As worship had started, few minutes later, he stepped out for ministration. While ministering, he spoke about a time to come and a time to leave, not knowing that it's already time. According to her, his statement was spiritual, and suddenly he left the stage and went into his inner chambers. She waited a few minutes and thereafter decided to check up on him, and she met him sitting on the chair like someone reflecting but unconscious. She quickly beckoned on his disciple, who came and tried to revive him, but to no avail. Of the truth, he went to be with the Lord and left us with the message, "Watch and pray." Many news came in place that TB Joshua died of stroke, although an official statement is yet to be communicated even to that effect. The popular prophet and televangelist was reportedly flown by ambulance to Turkey, where he finally died after battling with an unknown ailment, according to his wife. And this has raised eyebrows, and social media users have queried the man of God to visit hospitals when it is against the call of his preaching. His last moments on earth were spent in service to God. This is what he was born for, lived for, and died for. In his last word to Christians, he urged them to watch and pray. And he also said that on his birthday, he should be dedicated to fasting and prayer. So what are your thoughts about TB Joshua? What are your words for him? Comment in the comment section, and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel by clicking on the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to bell the notification button for more updates whenever I will post new videos. Follow us on Instagram at Ejimozy, Ejimozy, and also Favor Praise on Instagram. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.